You are watching a live broadcast coming to you from the Power of Faith Ministries, Lot 13, Portmore Town Center, St. Catherine, Jamaica, West Indies.
Please bring This is holy. This is holy. worship the Lord. Worship the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Good morning, church. We are going to begin our service this morning with the singing of the hymn 634 from our redemption. I just want to say good morning to all as you turn your hymnals to 634. It's a pleasure to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Is that amen? Amen. We are always thankful that we can gather into the house of the Lord to worship Him in the beauty of holiness. We have much to give God thanks for this morning. Hymn 634. On me. All power is given unto us, and it is endued by the power of the Holy Spirit when He comes into our lives and fills us. Hallelujah. So as we sing this song this morning, please reflect on the words. All power is given unto you by the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So we invite the Spirit to fall afresh on us this morning. Mighty God. Shenderebeke sent to the world. You are the eternal, self-existent one. There is none like you. You are the living God. All other gods are the works of men. But you, Lord, are the Most High God. Your word declare here, O Israel, for the Lord our God is one. O God existing in three beings, we thank you this morning, Triune God. As we approach your throne, we come boldly. Nothing in our hands we bring, but we look, oh God, to your cross, Jesus. The cross where you sacrifice to make redemption for us, so we can boldly come to your throne this morning, crying, Abba, Father. You are our Father. You are the God and Father of all flesh. And we thank you that we know you, whom to know is life everlasting. Father, your word declares that he that comes to you must believe that you are. And we know and we believe that you exist because we feel you in our souls. We see your hands at work in our lives and throughout creation. As your word declares, the heavens declare your glory. The firmament shows your handiwork. Nature speaks of your existence, because your word declares that in 6 days you created the heavens and the earth. You are creator, you are Lord, you are King, and we lift you up this morning. Father, as we come in this service, our aim and our desire is to lift you up. As the congregation gathers in corporate worship, we want to place you at the center of our focus this morning, because you tell us in your words that if you be lifted up, you will draw all men unto you. When we gather, Lord, to bless you, to praise you, to offer sacrifices of praise, to declare your words, to preach your gospel, to sing about you, the aim, God Almighty, is to bring men into your kingdom, because you have commissioned us so to do. So we ask this morning that as we come, as we sing, as we do all that we are planned to do on this program, you will sanction all our actions. You will lead and we will follow. Spirit of the living God, we ask that you fall afresh upon us this morning. Empower us, Lord, for the crisis that we are living in. It's a time of peril and violence and all manner of evil. But if you endure us with the power, as you have done and continue to do, and even some more in these wretched times, we know, God Almighty, that we can glorify you and you will draw men unto you. So our aim and desire is to lift you up this morning. It's not about us. It's all about you. We come here, God Almighty, together to declare that you are God, to worship and praise you so that you can bless us and those who are watching and hearing what we are saying this morning. So we ask, God, that you bless everything. Bless the choirs that will minister. Bless the spoken word. Let it be a rhema word straight from your throne. Lord, we ask that you grant us peace that will pass all understanding, for we recognize that the kingdom of God is not about meat or drink, oh God, but it's about righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. You promised to give us peace. Lord, we are living in a time when men's hearts are failing them for fear because of the turmoil and the tumult and the violence around us. But we look to you this morning, peace speaker, and we say peace speak, peace in our situations. God be with us. Bless the musicians. Oh God, bless the prayer mothers as they pray and intercede for the service. Oh God Almighty, touch the speaker that will come. Touch the kiddies. Touch everyone. Oh God, the presentations this morning. As we look to you, we ask that you save those who are in our presence and those who are watching us by the various media. We ask that you deliver those who are bound, those, God Almighty, who are sick, heal them. We ask, God Almighty, that you raise up in us, Lord Jesus, and in everyone, a song of praise that will cause deliverance. As Judah went first, praise went first, because it is a spiritual armor, oh God Almighty, it's a spiritual weapon. It is a spiritual weapon of change. So we send praise first. And so as we began our service praising you, we pray that you will consume us. We pray that you will take up preeminence in our midst. And we declare that we will glorify you and we will be blessed. This morning, we give it all to you, God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And let the church say, amen. Let the church say, amen. Let the church say, amen. Hallelujah. As you return to your seats, please, let us just continue in the mode of worship and praise. Whenever we gather believers, it's all about God. It's to declare his goodness. It's to honor him. It's to be thankful to him, because we are nothing in ourselves. We are failure. But as Lamentations declare, great is his faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies we see. All we have needed, his hands has provided. Are you experiencing the faithfulness of God this morning? Yes, he woke us up, clothed us in our right mind, set us on our way, gave us safe travel, and we are here in his house to honor him. Glory be to God. Again, I say good morning, one and all. Let me greet our bishop and his wife, Doctors Delford and Petrova Davis, our esteemed leaders. I want to greet you all, members, brothers, and sisters. We greet you well in the name of Jesus. This is Ladies Sunday. Women of Worth Department are in charge this morning under the leadership of Minister Tamika Peter King, and we have great things in store for you this morning. Just stay with us, just worship with us, just glorify the Lord with us, and you will reap the blessings. Please turn your Bibles with me to 2 Corinthians 3. We'll be reading the first 18 verses, and this will be done by worker Dana Thompson. That is 2 Corinthians 3, verses 1 to 18.
Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we lift up holy hands and magnify the King of Kings this morning? Hallelujah. I'll read as you follow. Do we begin again to commend ourselves, or need we, as some others, epistle of commendation to you, or letters of commendation from you? Ye are epistle written in our hearts, known and read of all men. For as much as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not in tables of stone, but in fleshy tables of the heart. And as such, trust have we through Christ to Godward, not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of God, who also has made us able ministers of the New Testament, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter killeth, but the Spirit giveth life. But if the ministration of death, written and engraved in stones, was glorious, so that the children of Israel could not steadfastly behold the face of Moses for the glory of his countenance, which glory was to be done away? How shall not the ministration of the Spirit be rather glorious? For if the ministration of condemnation be glory, much more doth the ministration of righteousness exceed the glory. For even that which was made glorious had no glory in this respect, by reason of the glory that excelleth. For if that which is done away was glorious, which more that which remaineth is glorious? Seeing then that we have such hope, we use great plainness of speech, and not as Moses, which put a veil over his face, that the children of Israel could not steadfastly look to the end of that which is abolished. But their minds were blinded, for until this day remaineth the same veil untaken away in the reading of the Old Testament, which veil is done away in Christ. But even unto this day, when Moses is read, the veil is upon their heart. Nevertheless, when it shall turn to the Lord, the veil shall be taken away. Now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even by the Spirit of the Lord. The Lord has spoken. Let the church say,
amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Raise your hands with me and say, Lord, show me your glory. Lord, show me your glory. Hallelujah. If that is the prayer of your heart this morning, you have to stay in tune with the Spirit to receive His glory. You may be seated. At this time, we'll receive the choir ministry of the Melodies of Praise Kiddies. Receive them in Jesus' name.
You tried to hide, but you couldn't conceal that your love and protection is all we could feel. A lot so hard. You made. You tried to hide, but you couldn't conceal that your love and protection is all we could feel. The love so hard. Whenever I needed a spark, I know the pressure to provide kept you up. Many a night, that your favorite words, now worry yourself, cause every little thing is gonna be alright. To love hard.
With arms wide open, you are my rock.
beautiful human being. You're the gift that keeps on giving. You're my Father. You're my Father. With arms wide open, you are my. A beautiful human being, you're the gift that keeps on giving. You're my Father, you're my Father. The gift that keeps on giving. You're my Father, you're my Father. You're the gift that keeps on giving. You're my Father,
you're my Father, you're my Father.
Mountain, sacrifices go unseen, but you are the gift that keeps on giving. And obviously you recognize that we are speaking about our fathers this morning. Today is International Father's Day, and we have many wonderful fathers in our midst this morning. Later in the program, we are going to be honoring your new fathers, so please stay tuned. At this time, we welcome Missionary Claudia Wade Gordon as she comes to do the official welcome.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's an honor and a privilege to stand here this morning. You are looking so lovely and beautiful. But hallelujah, I'm standing here this morning because of what God has done for me. He sent forth his only begotten Son that I may have life and have it more abundantly. And I'm eternally grateful for that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This morning, it is my privilege and pleasure to stand here to offer the welcome on behalf of our leaders, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis and our First Lady, Reverend Dr. Petrova Davis. They are indeed our leaders, and we give God thanks for them. This morning, again, it is our first service on this Our Lady's Sunday, and it is also celebrated as Father's Day. So give our men a round of applause. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. At this point, I stand and ask those who are visiting with us for the first and second time, could you stand to be specially acknowledged? Come on, don't be shy. Hallelujah. Give her a warm welcome. And if you're nearby, just give her a Holy Ghost greetings, because it's a privilege to have you. This is your Father's house. Be welcome. Be encouraged. You are loved and you are appreciated. Please have your seat. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We also pause to welcome those who have joined us on our social media platform, those who have joined us by cable channel network, and those who are viewing us or browsing us on the website. Please be welcome and be acknowledged. In 2 Corinthians, we read, "Therefore, come out from among them and be ye separate, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean things, and I will receive you. And I will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, said the Almighty God." Is there anyone in need of a father's guidance? Hallelujah. I give you Jesus this morning. He's more than a father. He's a father to the faithless. He's a father to all of us who needs that love. Hallelujah. So we appreciate our Heavenly Father, and we appreciate those men who have stood up in the capacity as fathers to help us along the way. We give you thanks. Again, I come as I make my descent. Welcome. You are welcome in the house of the Lord. You are welcome wherever you have joined us. Let the Spirit of God rest upon you. Let the peace of God overshadow you. And please stay tuned for the rest of the service. You will be blessed and encouraged in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Missionary Gordon. Hallelujah. So it is at this time, at this juncture of the service, that we want to honor our fathers on this Father's Day. Today is celebrated worldwide as Father's Day, a time when families spend taking time out to appreciate and honor their fathers, honor fathers all over for the wonderful work they do in caring for their families. We at the Power Faith Ministries this morning, under the auspices of the Women of Worth Department, want to join the world in doing the same. We want to take time out to honor our fathers this morning. Minister Peter King and her team will be taking their positions now, and we ask your fathers to just pay attention to the instructions that you'll be given. We ask and implore you to really appreciate, we really appreciate you. You are doing great, and we want to honor and respect you for what you are doing. The society would not be the same without you. Before we go into the general presentation, I want to take time out to honor our spiritual father, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis. Go ahead, congregation. You always are spontaneous. You do not wait to be directed to honor our bishop at no time at all. And that speaks volume of the measure of this man, a great man. You do not have to be prompted. Thank you. You may be seated. Bishop Davis, we honor you this morning, sir. I want to use the letters of the word father to really identify some qualities I personally see in you as a good father. F, you are faithful and fearless. A, you are alert, astute, and attentive. T, you are tenacious and tactical. H, you are humorous, and we really enjoy that personality trait of you, of yours. You are humble, honest, and humane. You are also energetic, endearing, empathetic, and engaging. And as a spiritual man, you are reverential, respectful, and resourceful. Could the ladies in the congregation stand for me? And after two, Bishop Davis, could you please stand also, sir? After two, please point to our bishop and say, Happy Father's Day. One, two. It gives me pleasure, sir, to give you this token of our appreciation and love for you. Please receive it from our hearts to yours. Ladies, you may be seated. Gentlemen, there are some ladies in the aisles, and customarily, we would ask you, gentlemen, to remain in your seats. But this morning, we want you to be highlighted. We want to put you on display. So as you see, there is this thing right here. We want you to walk down, strut your stuff down this aisle. Take a catwalk. Let us see you on display. By the instruction of the ladies, you'll be coming from the back. Come down the center aisle. Take a bow and please take one of the tokens that we have prepared from you, from the ladies in this basket. Go ahead while control room entertains us. Fathers, listen to the song that has been played for you this morning. Listen to the words. You may go ahead, ladies.
They say they don't know how to marry, we just they worry. Daddies, them say all we do is to run away from the babies. Daddies, every day we do this and that. Them say we no be responsible, no be everybody day like that. It just be funny, cause if man no day, if puppy no day, then waiting we get. If man no day, man no day, how we go exist. Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to every man with a financial responsibility.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to every man when you do everything for the family.
If man no day, if poppy no day, then waiting we day. If man no day, if man no day, me day you no go day. Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to every man with a financial responsibility.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to you.
Happy Father's Day
to every man with a do everything.
Control room, could you just take it down a notch, please? Could you just lower the volume a little, please? At this time, while the presentation is going on, I invite Minister Janet Small to do a special presentation.
Hallelujah, Jesus. And all because of our spiritual daddy. Hallelujah, Jesus. We give God praise for him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's not take what we have for granted. Glory to God. I'm going to be asking Bishop Dr. Delford Davis to stand at this time. Glory, glory, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. We place you, Almighty God, in the highest place. For you, glory to God, you are the great high priest, our founder, our apostle, our end time preacher. Glory to God. Bishop the Reverend Dr. Delford Davis, continue to give him that round of applause. Hallelujah, Jesus. Look at what is happening. Because of his grace, because of his obedience to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Sir Bishop Davis, we first want to greet you, and I add to Minister Matthew's greeting from all of us, the local assembly, as our spiritual dad. This greetings is coming from the Miramar Assembly, Bishop Michael Hutchinson and the saints back there, and also from all the overseas assembly. And it reads, Father's Day greetings to our presiding bishop, founder and general overseer, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis. It is indeed an honor to acknowledge our spiritual father this morning, this special morning. True fathers are those who care, those who will be there, those who make the sacrifices to ensure that the children are taken care of. Fathers encourage, motivate, and lead the children by their own examples. I celebrate you this morning, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis, for being such a special father to so many. May your today's and tomorrow's be filled with the blessings of Almighty God in Jesus' name. Happy Father's Day from all of us, both overseas and locally. Bishop Dr. Delford Davis, we love and appreciate you, and we pray that the good Lord will continue to strengthen, protect, cover, and let you continue to blaze the trail for God. Congregation, please put your hands together for him. Bishop, we love you. Stand to your feet and point your hands at him and say, bless him, Lord. Bless him, Lord. Strengthen him, Lord. Strengthen him, Lord. Cover him, Lord. Cover him, Lord. Glory to God. We love and appreciate you. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Minister Janet Small for that. And fathers, we hope that you enjoyed our presentation. Enjoy the rest of your day. It was my pleasure doing this presentation on behalf of the Women of Worth Department this morning. At this time, we will be receiving the ministry of the Voices of Triumph. After the Voices of Triumph minister, our bishop, the first gentleman, the first father of this assembly, will come to us and do the rest of the service. Take care. Bless you.
Hallelujah. Shall we praise the Lord? Come on, just wave your hands in his presence and say hallelujah. Wave your hands in his presence and say thank you, Jesus. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, just say Jesus. Just say Jesus. It's a beautiful name. Just say Jesus. Hallelujah. Worthy to be praised. You are the world.
is in the house of God. Don't hold it back. Come on, give him praise and glory. Celebrate the great God of heaven, the one who has made all things beautiful and has made all things possible for us. He's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. Praise ye the Lord. Clap your hand and shout the high praise to Almighty God. Bless you. Be seated, please. What a celebration. Celebrating fathers. Father of the world, you are the light within me. God of all creation, living in my heart. I will praise you, Lord, for all your love and mercy. He alone is worthy to be praised. Lend my voice to that of the moderator and others to say a very special Father's Day greeting and blessings to all fathers in my audience, here and now, whenever and wherever, home and abroad. May God ever bless you, good, godly gentlemen, and indeed all fathers, whether you be good and godly or not, you are a father. And he wants everybody to be the best they can for his glory and for his honor, for the family and for the nation. Certainly for the church of the living God. So we celebrate you. We thank the Women of Worth Department for the wonderful exercise of distributing tokens to all the fathers, and I believe the same thing will obtain in the second service. Nobody's saying nothing. All right, so you fathers who are not here for this one, make sure you make it for the second one at 10 a.m. Your token is here waiting for you. Nobody else won't get it but you, okay? So make sure you come get it personally. God is good. I want to make a very special request before I continue greeting. Well, time goes so fast. That next Sunday, Exhorter Kerry and Beckford Thomas, if you could return all those children for Youth Sunday, okay? What a tremendous show of the tomorrow's generation, which is actually today's generation. Most of them are wiser than most of us. I make that special request because we'll have some officials from the Ministry of Education here on next Sunday, and to speak to our youths and children. So I really love for you to bring them back and let whomever speak to them. Amen. So let me greet everybody once again, Dr. Petrova. It's not Mother's Day, it's Father's Day, okay? Happy Mother's Father's Day, okay? Lord bless you. And may he bless all these wonderful mothers and fathers, everybody, and both sides and all sides. Give them a big hand, please. My preaching time is almost gone. Lord, have mercy. We want to acknowledge Bishop Dr. V.T. Williams, my spiritual father. Put your hands together for the man of God. The church will be celebrating him today on his 91st birthday. Yeah. And I could tell you more, but I say no more. I was hoping to drop by for a few minutes today. I hope I can make it, JEC, because I'll be preaching both services. I don't know. We'll see what happens. You got to respect your father. Come on, say something. And all of you wonderful men who look so resplendently deported this morning, walking down the aisles, I want to see all of you gentlemen on Tuesday night and all the others for our special men's gathering. I hope to see you 7 o'clock on the dot. We are going to be making some deposits. You don't have to worry if you're not saved and you don't want to get saved. We won't get you saved, okay? Don't worry about that. But we want you to come by. We've got some things to share with you. Bishop the Reverend Dr. Al Miller and myself will be the presenters. And you are going to be challenged. You're going to be inspired. You're going to be blessed. Let all the men stand, please. Just stand again for a few seconds. Now, can you believe this? Look across this auditorium. My God. Look behind me, around me, before me, beside me. God bless you, gentlemen. Thank you so much. Be seated. So this is my very special invitation for you to join us. 7 o'clock. All of you taxi men and bus drivers, park up the taxi for the 2 hours. You can park up the bus. It's not yours, okay? But come by. You will be blessed. Amen. Today is lined up for a great day. 10 o'clock, we continue. And 5:30 this afternoon. That's the big, 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 big one. Right here, so. Right here, so. Everybody say, right here, so. Men and women from everywhere, right here, so. 5:30 p.m. I want to thank those who exercise the all-night prayer meeting on Friday night. Well, I had a very long day. I did a wonderful teaching and set the pace for you. Bless you, Missionary Parish, and all the team. Amen. God bless you. Let's acknowledge Deacon Duane Fuller, his wife, Evangelist Andrea Fuller, and little Evangelist Deidrea Fuller. Would you stand and come down here, please? Yeah, come. From the Miramar Assembly in Florida. Some of you remember Deacon Fuller and his wife. You've never met this little evangelist, Deidre. Aren't you glad to be in Jamaica? Take down your mask. Come on, you'll be safe. Aren't you glad to be here?
Yes, I am.
You are. You're a little preacher, aren't you?
Yes.
Do you want to preach for me this morning?
Well, yes.
The Bible says, lay hands suddenly on no man. So I will not lay hands suddenly on you, okay? But it's good to have you in Jamaica for the first time. You're born in America. All American. Good to have you. Deacon Duane Fuller and his wife. She worked as my secretary some years ago, isn't it? Andrea, yeah. You were the one that brought the baby and said, was it you? Your baby? Yeah. Baby was about dying, and you brought the child, didn't know what to do. My God, and she brought her to Sister Andrea. She said, okay, let's take her. So the man of God, the office was right here, and God Almighty, God just resurrect the child and give her victory. Good to have all three of you. The Lord bless you. We'll hear. Happy birthday to you, sir, and happy Father's Day. Give them a big hand, please. God bless you. Wonderful. Lord, have mercy. Deacon Fuller is a wonderful servant of the Lord. You know him quite well. And so his wife. She's in charge of the prayer department there in Miramar and doing a fantastic job. God bless them. What else do I say and take the other 35 minutes to preach to you? I say, okay, those at Olympia Crown will be with you for 3 more services, 23rd, 28th, and 30th. 23, 28, and 30. No meeting there on Tuesday night. All the men should be here for a special men's gathering. And finally, I want every member, every Christian should get a copy of this. You should get a copy. Biblical Doctrines for All Christians. You should get a copy. Power of Faith Churches. Most of you are viewing now, well, some of you at least. Ask your pastor for a copy, okay? Grove Road, Goshen, Bogwalk, Atfield, Knightsville, Miramar, St. Petersburg, Brooklyn, Bronx, Toronto, and Portmore. Ask your pastor for a copy. You must get one to study the fundamental doctrines of God's church. So you can defend your faith when you need to stand flat-footed and defend your faith. If you have to save your offerings for 1 month, don't give no offering for 1 month and save the $2,000 and get your copy, do so. If you have to cut back on your lunch and cut back on some activities that you can reduce, it is worth doing. Did you hear what I say? Don't give any offering for 1 month if that's what you need to do to get your copy. 2,000 Jamaican dollars to take care of the printing costs. We can't give it to you free. Some of you love too much freeness. Invest in your spiritual life. God has blessed Dr. Petrova to do a lot of work, research, study, night and day. She should be honored for this volume, the first of its kind in this ministry. All those who have already got your copy, let me see your hand, please. Lift them high. See what I mean? I can't make it plainer. Save your offering and get your copy. Do a day's, 2 days fasting and get your copy. I can't tell you save your tithes. I can't do that because I'd be robbing God. I can't do that. But I can tell you save your offering. Jesus, Jesus. That's how serious it is. People from other churches have begun to purchase them. Other churches. And why we are neglecting the gift that God has blessed us with. So much for all of that. The text was read earlier, but before we do, stand up, please. We have something to celebrate. What are you celebrating, Bishop? Put your hands together, everybody. Yesterday morning at about 8:32 a.m., our brother Wilberforce Peter King leave from her to heaven, and he has arrived safely on Canaan's land. Let's put our hands together and celebrate his safe arrival to glory. Are you not celebrating? That's what the Bible says we are to do. Yeah. Bishop, you're funny. Oh, I'm not. Now we can pray for Minister Peter King and the Peter King's family But father, grandfather, father-in-law has safely arrived home to glory. Come on, clap your hands and praise God. So pray for the family. God will be with them. Let us pray. Grant us your Holy Spirit's presence, O God, as we enter upon the word. Grant that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart will be acceptable in your sight. And for the few moments I share the word, let it be quick, powerful, sharper than any to which it soared. Let it serve every intended purposes today. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Glory. Be seated, please. Lift your right hand and say, it must be seen, it must be felt, my Christian influence. One more time, it must be seen, it must be felt. What is it? Yeah, you think I was finished? Still coming on, and I'll do it again at 10 o'clock, concluding this powerful series by the grace of God. We spoke concerning influence according to scholastic definitions, dictionary definitions, to be the ability or power to inspire or to motivate an individual to act in one way or another. You can sway them one way or another because you are influential. We spoke of it as being the ability or capacity to have an effect or impact upon another person or many persons. We spoke to influence concerning influence as being the capacity to affect human action, human behavior, and even human opinion. That's how powerful influence is. We also spoke concerning influence to be able to have an impact on something or someone. And finally, the capacity to have an effect on the character, the development, or the behavior of someone. That is how powerful influence is. I've said many things which I will not rehearse, but we spoke concerning us being salt. We know what salt does. It preserves. We spoke concerning us being witness. We know what witnesses do. What do they do? Testify. We spoke concerning us being light. What light does? It's illuminating. We spoke concerning us being branch or branches. And what is it that is expected of a branch? To bear fruit. Today we speak of us. We speak concerning to our influence as being epistle. Lift your hand and say, I am an epistle. I am an epistle. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, Paul says in verse 2, ye are our epistle, written in our hearts, known and read of some men. Look in the book, please. Look in the book. Don't you look on me, look in the book. You are our epistle in our hearts, known and read of all men. Anywhere you go, as a child of God, somebody is watching you. Anywhere you go as a child of God, somebody's expecting something above the ordinary from you. The very fact that they know that you're a Christian, they expect you to live above the world. It doesn't matter how much Satan's darts are hurled at you. By the grace of God, we are expected to live above the world. Lift your hand and say, above the world. Take your time. You think I'm not going to preach, okay? God expects us to be standing up and standing out for him under all circumstances. The devil wants to keep us down, but he will not be able to keep us down. For greater is he that is in me, us, we that he that is in the world. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Jesus. Some people in your community has never opened their Bible for the last 6 months. But they have a Bible in their house. It is being covered with dust. They don't open it. But every time you walk in that community, they're reading you. They read your life. Oh, God, help me in this house. Read and seen of all men. Amen. That's all outstanding we are as Christians. And what epistle was meant to do? Epistle was meant to instruct. Give instruction. Epistle was meant also to proclaim, to propagate. And when you look at the Pauline epistles from Romans to Philemon, somebody might say from Romans to Hebrews, when you read those epistles of the Apostle Paul, they give to all of us godly and good conduct that we should manifest in life. They say to us, you are no longer the old creature. Old things are. Somebody finish it for me. All things are passed away and behold. All things become new. I pray to God the day will really come when the Christian community will stand up as we ought to stand up. I pray the day will come when we will shine as we ought to shine. I pray the day will come when we will be penetrating the atmosphere and men will recognize that we are here on purpose. We are here as light and salt, branch, epistle, and ambassadors. We are here representing the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Who don't like it, that's their problem. But we are here on mission for God. Somebody praise God and let your belly roll. The devil is a liar. Glory to the, oh God Almighty. Praise him, voices of triumph. Hallelujah. So as epistle that are seen, what the word says, you are our epistle, amen, written in our hearts, known and read of all men. Known and read of all men. All who never knew you before you became born again. The very day you became born again, a new chapter has opened in your life. And people begin to read you. Christianity don't mean you join a church or get baptized and join a church and have your name on the roll. It's way beyond that. It means a change of heart, a change of life, a change of mind, a change of direction. So those of you in church messing around and living all kind of shock up dirty life, come out of that. You better let me talk my heart here today. Those of you giving church bad name. And let the world see. I saw the whole of them turn. I lied them a tale. A youth answer. And I saw all of us there. There's a difference between the clean and the unclean. There's a difference between the holy and the unholy. There are those in Sardis that will not defile. If I have anybody in here today who say, by the grace of God, I will keep my garment clean. Wave your hand and say, by the grace.
grace of God, I will not defile. The days of hypocrisy must be over. Come straight, come clean, come right. If you love world, stay a world. If you love church, sit down in a church and obey God's word. Come on, Bishop, what happened to you? What's wrong with me? God Almighty, somebody help me. Praise him over here. Praise him over here. Read and seen of all men. I said to someone recently, I said, friend, be careful what you do. Because in Jamaica, we say bush of ears and stone of eyes. Oh, no. Bush of ears and stone of eyes. Amen. So people around you who you think are not seeing you and are not hearing you, you make a sudden mistake. They may act as though they're not listening and they're not looking. But wait until, lift your hand and say, bush of ears, say stone of eyes, say bush of ears, say stone of eyes. Shakunda masatarabaha. Somebody praise God in this house with me. Our weakness must be seen. And our weakness must be felt. Seen and felt. The impact of the Christians of the first century church. Oh my God Almighty. We soon tell you a little more about that. They were a force to be reckoned with. Everybody knew that they were around. Because their influence was seen. And it was felt. You could not deny the existence of the early church. Anywhere they go, you could not deny. Oh, they're making a difference. Let's try and see if we can sit down, please. Get some of this in. Mm-mm. Jesus, living epistles must be felt. Let's look at Acts chapter 17, please. Glory to God. Acts chapter 17, and look at verse 5 and 6. Let's see what we find there. 17, 5 and 6. It says, but the Jews which believed not, moved with envy, took unto them certain lewd fellows of the baser sort. And we have some lewd fellows today of the baser sort who are causing problem in our nation. Lewd fellows of the baser sort, and God Almighty, you know we are living in serious time. Lewd fellows, baser sort, gathered a company. Companies are being gathered today everywhere you turn. Gathered a company and set all the city on an uproar. Baser people, lewd people, mashing up Jamaica. Be they gunmen, knife men, rapists, scammers, sinners of every sort. You are the problem in the nation. It's not the church. Righteousness exalts. Somebody say something there. Righteousness exalts the nation, but sin is a reproach unto any people. The base of sorts. The lewd people. Gather them. Make an uproar. Amen. And assaulted the house of Jason, and sought to bring them out to the people. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, saying, what did they say of them? Read the Bible, come on. These that have turned the world upside down. Glory to God. Glory to God. Somebody say something down there. These that have turned the world upside down. God needs some spiritual revolutionaries in the world today. I told the group on Friday night, these are not the days when we sit down and fight from a defensive position. We have to become offensive. Because Jesus said, from the days of John until today, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent took it. There is a church. The violent took it by force. If we are going to get some things done, if we are going to make some inroads, if we are going to turn the world as it ought to be turned, we can't just sit in our defensive position. We must become onward Christian soldiers, marching as to war, with the cross of Jesus going on before. God, somebody help me, praise him here. I feel the touch of God's Holy Spirit ministering to me. My heart bleeds, my heart cries out for the state of our nation. Oh, glory to God. These have turned the world upside down are come either also. Hold on. We cannot settle for the status quo as it now exists. Now let me explain what I mean by that. The status quo in Christendom is just be a wonderful person, being in your church, doing the duties of the church. Just enjoy yourself. Hold on. Very soon, if God don't have mercy, some of us wonderful people who want to come to our church and enjoy fun and air condition and fellowship among wonderful brothers and sisters and greet and the camaraderie among us. If God don't have mercy very soon, you can't lift your yard. You'll be afraid to leave your house. Right now, many people are afraid to leave their house. Because evil men are everywhere. Somebody say something down there. But the Lord rebuke the base assault. The Lord rebuke the lewd people. The Lord rebuke the base assault. The Lord rebuke the lewd people. And may the church of the living God, as God's epistle, read and seen of all men, may we take our stand. Lift your hand and say, by the grace of God, I will take my stand. Say, by the grace of God, I will not compromise my faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody is depending on you, my brother. Somebody is depending on you, my sister. They may not have told you, but they are admiring your walk. And you may not know how much your life, your Christian influence, has been impacting the lives of many people. It has caused some people to be in check. In check. Because when they see the good works of Brother John, Sister Mary, they say, oh no, I got to take some example. They may not be born again Christians at this time, but they are feeding from you. And it's only a matter of time they will bow their hearts to the Savior, because your Christian influence was seen and it was felt. These have to turn the world upside down. You think they were messing up the world? No, they were setting their world in right order. They were establishing kingdom principles. They were establishing righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost according to Romans 14, 17. That's what the kingdom is all about. Lift your hand and say, the kingdom of God is not meat and drink. Lift up your hand. Some of you are too lazy. Lift up your hand. Come on. Get rid of arthritis if it is there. So the kingdom of heaven is not meat. It's not drink. It's righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Shako Sandia. Who is going to carry righteousness, peace, and joy? Who is going to carry it? Who has the Holy Ghost? Oh God Almighty. In whom the Holy Ghost dwells. If righteousness, peace, and joy is to permeate our society, permeate the workplace, permeate, penetrate the home, the schools, and everywhere, who will be those epistles? Talk to me. I'm challenging you, you know, because I want some of you to wake up. I mean, real wake up. Because you, some of you seem to think that your Christianity is all about you. All about who? It was never meant to be about you. Oh no. Jesus. Jesus. It was never meant to be about you. God placed a treasure in earthen vessel. And he wants the excellency of the power that manifests is not of us. It is of God to accomplish God's mission, to serve God's purpose, so that thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is ordained in heaven. Lift your hand and say, I am a child of the kingdom. Come on, kingdom kids. God of heaven. Come on, kingdom kids. Come on, kingdom kids. Come on, light. Come on, salt. Come on, epistle. Come on. Do your work. And you do your work sometime without even saying a word. A wonderful sister in New York. Sister Bishop, my goodness, I've been following these series of messages. And when you said, Bishop Dr. Ronald Blair said of someone, sister, that she said the thing is better felt than telt. She said, dear God, that sunk within me, because I realized that I don't have to even open my mouth sometimes. Just the way I walk. Just the life I live. What do we sing? Let the life that I live. Let the life that I live. Let the life that I live speak for me. Woo! You are. You know, I can't really get into the depth of this. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Because when you heard the lesson read, you see that it gave a narration, a comparison between Moses and Christ, between Moses' glory and Jesus' glory. Moses' glory was temporary to be done away with, but the glory of Christ is permanent, will never be done away with. It speaks of the two covenant, law and grace. You want to understand some more of that? Get this book. get it. It speaks of the covenant, oh God Almighty, from Sinai, Moses. And it speaks of the other from Calvary, Jesus Christ. John 1 and verse 7 says, for the law was given. Finish it, Naman. The law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Somebody praise him. And he said, if that glory of Moses was so glorious, if that temporary glory which would be done away with, are you not saying nothing there? If it was so glorious, ministers, that the people could not look upon Moses with their naked eyes, they had to put a veil over their face. For the glory that was upon Moses, how much more? Shakundamasata. Somebody wave your hand in his presence. Lift your hand and say, Lord, take me into that glory. Take me into that glory. Take me into that dimension. Take me a little higher, a little deeper, a little wider. Shamako sendiria. Ramasakotoe. I feel a touch of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Moses was on the scene, but for a while. And he would have to leave the scene. But Jesus Christ, a priest forever, after the order of Melchizedek, has brought us into a new covenant. Dear God in heaven, do we really know who we are? Do we really know what we have? Do we really know what we have been brought into? Partakers of the divine nature, served under the heavenly calling, under the high priesthood of Jesus Christ, who lives forever. He lives. He lives. Christ Jesus lives today. Somebody say, he walks with me and he talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives. He lives. Salvation to impart. If you ask me, oh, somebody better ask your neighbor beside you, how do you know he lives? How do you know he lives? How do you, who told you that he lives? Where did you get the argument from? Where did you read it from? Oh no, I got it from nobody. He lives within. Shakendobusata. He lives within my heart. Oh, glory to God. Oh, God of heaven. Somebody wave your hand and praise God in the Holy Ghost. The devil is a liar. He wants to keep us down. He wants to tell us we amount to nothing, but we are more than conquerors. We are the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, strong and not weak, victorious and not defeated. Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah. Your Christian influence must be felt as it is seen. Let's move along. Let's turn to Acts chapter 8. Oh God, my time is really gone. Acts chapter 8. Somebody shout a praise down there. You know the story. Philip went down to Samaria. Lift your hand and say, I am a type of Philip. Come on, man, preach with me. Say, I am a type of Philip. I must go down to Samaria. My message is needed down there. Philip, anointed by the Holy Ghost. I'm saying our Christian influence must be seen and it must be felt. Then Philip went down to Samaria, the city of Samaria, and preached Christ.
released unto them. And the people with one accord gave heed. Hallelujah. Gave heed unto those things which Philip spake. Hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. For unclean spirits, crying with loud voice, came out of many that were possessed with them, and many taken with the palsy and that were lamed were healed. Let's continue the reading. And there was great joy in the city, great sorrow in Spanish Town, great sorrow in St. James all over, great sorrow in Clarendon, and in every parish of Jamaica, in every district of Jamaica, there is a lamentation, there is weeping, there is mourning. Am I preaching to anybody here? What it says, Philip need to step out, step down, step up. You know, a minister may be here next Sunday, minister of government, somebody, yeah. And I hail all the social programs. I laud them for their philanthropic work and for going into communities to do this and do that. But let me tell you, church, it doesn't matter what governments do. There is a job in each community to be done. Money can't do it. Which political party you support can't do it. Who you voted for can't do it. Who you member of parliament, your councillor, whoever it is, can't do it. All right? They can't. Because they've not been anointed for that task. So, should the task be left undone? Come talk to me, no man. They cannot do it. What does it mean? Should it be left undone? Should the communities continue to weep and mourn and bawl and lament? The gunning down of my sons and my daughters. The burning down of my house. The raping of my children. Should they continue? Isn't there somebody that should go and bring joy into the city? And the problem is, each of us are waiting on the other. Yeah. But you better work out your own. You better realize that every man will be paid according to your work shall be. You know, I don't blame some of you just enjoying this church and just come and worship. I don't blame you. Because maybe that's your portion. But some of us have a little more than that. Let me try and bring it down. Okay. So Philip went down to Samaria and preached Christ unto the people, because the city was bombarded by sorcery. Hobia man. Do people still go to Hobia people in Jamaica? Okay. Still go to Hobia man. I thought the days of Hobia workers were over. With this, come on, I really thought so. Huh? Sorcerers are still doing business. People are still supporting them. We need Philip into Samaria to preach Christ unto the people. We need the Simons of this earth to realize that there is a greater power. We need the Simons, the sorcerers, to come to realize that all power is given. And not only Simon, but we need the people themselves to turn from evil and turn to the living God. And joy was in the city. Lift your hand and say, Lord, help me to enter my Samaria, wherever that is, and to bring joy to the people around me. Say, Lord, I have a Samaria right where I live, where I work, where I walk, where I drive, where I worship. Help me, Jesus, to bring joy to somebody. Your Christian influence as an epistle, you must be seen and you must be felt. Samaria was never the same again because an anointed deacon went down there, or evangelist went down there and preached Christ unto them. As salt, are you penetrating and flavoring? As light, are you shining? As branch, have you been bearing the fruits that will attract people's eyes? Oh, what beautiful fruits on that tree. They will not look on bare leaves and branches, but I guarantee you fruits are in there. Birds are going to lurk around. Lizards are going to lurk around. Oh, glory to God. Fruits on your tree and on my tree will cause our weakness to be seen. Glory to God. As an epistle of the Lord Jesus Christ, who ought to be up and around instructing. That's what the Pauline epistles do. They instruct us, inviting us to live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for the glorious appearing of our great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself to cleanse us from all our sins and iniquities and to purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works, Titus chapter 2 and verse 11 and 12. That's what God says of us today. And I challenge you to let your Christian influence be seen and let it be felt. Shake everything around you by the power of God. Influence everything around you. Oh, let me say this and quit. You may not know how many persons you have saved because of your godly lifestyle. You may not know. They don't tell you. But some persons who would have done certain things, but because they see you and they know you, and especially if you have talked with them somewhere along the line, they says, oh no, I can't do that. Your influence was felt upon them, although they have not yet surrendered to Christ. God help us today that our Christian influence will be seen and it will be felt in this age and time. And the best of the series comes at 10 o'clock today when we speak of us being stewards. Lift your hand and say, I am a steward. You're going to see the responsibility of stewards. You're going to see the expectations of the master in relation to stewards. And when we see them, may God help us to do all that we can to make a difference. Bow your heads with me, please. Everyone who is seated, put your hands on your knees, both knees, if you can. If you want to do so, you don't want to do so, no problem. You're on your knees. Knees. Representing the strength. Gives mobility. to the body. Strengthen the feeble knees. The Bible speaks of that. Strengthen the feeble knees. I pray for you now in a spiritual sense that God would strengthen your spiritual knees. Roshanda makosata. And while he strengthens your spiritual knees, he will heal those hurting knees and strengthen them so you can mount up as you ought to, so you can stand as you ought to. Some of you gonna feel a little burning in your knees. Yeah, I did say that. Shako masanda. Let me go a little further. When you feel the burning in your knees, when you feel the burning in your knees, I want you to jump on your feet. Don't you jump up if you don't feel the burning, because I know you're gonna feel it, especially those who are sick in your knees. Shako namaseta. Rababako satama. In the name of Jesus, God, you said the feeble knees must be strengthened. I speak the fire of God. Oh, Jesus. I speak the fire of God in every knee this morning. I speak the fire of God in those knees. And I say they must be strengthened. As they are strengthened physically, as they are healed physically, so may they be healed in the spirit, so that every epistle of yours will be able to stand up and stand out. I speak into those cracking knee joints. I speak to those arthritic conditions. Woo! In the name of Jesus, come out. Come out. Come out. In the name of Jesus, come out. Echo Shata Mahanda. Yeah, the fire begin to penetrate right now. Come out in the name of Jesus. We will not be held down. Hey, by feeble knees. Shakonda basetorabaha. Iryo Shamahasata. Be healed. And as you are healed physically, come on, be healed spiritually. Oh, in the name, in the name, in the name, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God. Glory to God. Jump up on your feet, lift up your hands and give him praise in the house of God. Jump up on your feet, lift up your hands and give him praise in the house of God. Give him praise in the house of God. Give him praise in the house of God. Let the redeemed of the Lord, Shabbat the Lord, Shabbat the Lord, praise him until your belly feel living water. Endo sakora baba hondi. Come on, come on, come on. This is the way I'm closing it down. This is the way I'm closing it down. But some of you gotta take a touch from heaven. You gotta take a touch from heaven. You gotta get an anointing from the Holy One of Israel. Take an anointing so you can run through your troop. Take an anointing so you can climb over your walls. Take an anointing so you can bring down your Goliath. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Back up, devil, back up, back out, back up, back up, back up, back out, back up, back out. Zion is in session. The church is alive. Hey, Rosata Mandaha. Rabako Shetemehuye.
God, we pray. Yes, we praise you. God, we praise you. God, we adore you. God, we magnify you. Bless your people. Heal your people. Deliver your people. Set your people free. Home and abroad. Every father on this Father's Day. Every man on this Father's Day. Every home, every family, in every nation. Show yourself strong. Show yourself mighty. Because you're strong. Because you're mighty. Yes, sir. Clap your hand and shout the high praise to God Almighty. Clap your hand and shout the high praise to the Almighty God. Yes, sir. Holy Ghost of God. Do your thing. Save, heal, deliver, set free. Save, heal, deliver, set free. Save, heal, deliver, set free. In Jesus' name. For I am healed by the wound in his side. I am healed by the wound. Hallelujah. Lift your hand and say, I am healed by the wound. In my Savior's side. I am healed by the wound. In just one more time. Physical healing, spiritual healing, financial healing, marital healing. Thank you today for your blessings. We thank you for the word you have sent. We thank you for the challenge it presents to the hearts of your people. We pray that the word will work for unsaved and backsliders. Save them. Reclaim them. We pray that the word will work for believers. Strengthen us. Reaffirm and establish us so that as epistles read and seen of all men, we will give the instructions that we ought to give. We will propagate the word of life. You shall be glorified. Thank you for your blessings upon us. Thank you for the anointing of your Holy Spirit. Let no stone be left unturned as you minister to your people here and now and always. In Jesus' name. Amen. Clap your hands and give him praise. Clap your hands and give him praise. Bless you. Be seated, please.
going to delay the service for another 30 minutes. It means that we are going to be collecting our tithes and offering right now. And we are going to be calling some more names of persons to receive your dedicated servant leader certificate. Many, many, many persons are yet to do so. We do call names earlier in the morning, but we realize what's happening. All those who gave your name, not yet received your certificate, let me see your hand, please. You had written your name, submitted. Lift them high. All right, we hope we'll get to you in the next 15, 20 minutes. Father, bless our gifts of tithes and offering. It is out of thine own that we give back to thee. We thank you that you have blessed our resources so that we can take care of our needs and assist others and support your church with our tithes and offering. Bless, we pray, gifts and givers in Jesus' name. The ushers lead us in giving, and all persons thereafter, you can prepare to do so. We will defer the announcements for this morning. You know exactly what they are, especially for the remainder of this week and the remainder of this month. This evening will be a very special service. 5:30 for everybody, visitors and everybody alike. So whilst you walk down to give your offering and tithes, names will be called simultaneously, same time. You hear your name, come and collect your certificates, and we will do the statement of affirmation immediately thereafter and have you dismissed 9:45. The Lord bless you. Please proceed as you ought to.
Bless the Lord. Sonia Edwards, Damian Evans, Patricia Evans Brown, Jean Evans, Charmaine Ellis Graham, Yvette Edwards, Carlene Emmanuel, Sharika Ennis, Alexia Edwards, Joyce Ellis, Vivian Edwards, Sonia Ellis Williams, Dion Ebanks Daly, Tatina Elliott, Anthony Errar, Enid Edwards Gordon, Raina Everett, Diana Knight, Angela Furtado King, Camelia King, Ellerine Cadillo, Shirley Carr, Dawn Kelly.
Please listen attentively, and once you hear a name, come down here. Some one of these ladies.
Evelyn Lambert Campbell.
Find your certificate.
Angela Leslie. Sandra Harris. Kamoya Leslie. Dosia Lawrence. Lisa Leslie Blair. Bibi Lorraine. Jefferson Lamy. Sharon Lawrence. Yvette Lettman. Leon Lee. Rupert Laws. Karen Lawson. Anne-Marie Lawrence, Floretta Lennon-Lewis, Alterine Latour, Rayan Lewis, Rajan Lewis, Cadian Leslie, Pauline Lindsay, Beverly Lewis, Christopher Lewis, Rowan Levy, Yvonne Linton, Mikael Lee, Earl Lewis, Leston Lawrence, Patricia Lewis, Donet Lewis Osborne, Jennifer Lewis, Karen Levy, Chanel Lee, Angela Lewis, Kadisha Lawrence, Carrion Lennon, Lorraine Leach, Alterine Latour, Elva Levy. Michael Fletcher. Violet Francis. Sophia Francis. Loretta Francis. Barbara Fagan. Paulette Francis. Doreen Fraser. Ruby Francis. Suzette Fuller. Carlene Francis Stewart. Sandra Fennell. Renelle Fennell. Marjorie Facy Thompson. Winsome Ferguson. Sandra Finley. Amanda Foster. Aston Foster. Muriel Fraser. Sidonie Fagan. Dennis Folks. Gloria Findlay. Eugenie Hall. Alvin Francis. Tanya Graham. Michelle Grant. Lorraine Green. Angela Goh. Taslin Golding. Sharon Gale. Grace Gordon. Roy Graham. Jennifer Gordon. Evadne Gordon. Anita Gordon. Norma Gans Miller. Opal Gentles. Carl Garden. Alfio Alexander. Merlene Green. Nadine Goodwin. Audrey Gibbs Hall. Rosetta Grant. Shanelia Gonzalez. Antoinette Garrick. Shauna Garrick. Pauline Gordon. Karen Gray Anthony. Patrona Gordon. Keisha Gossop Williams. Anita Gordon Whittingham. Megan Gordon. Marlene Gordon.
Okay, hold a minute. Let them sort out what is down here, please. You're standing down here because your name was called. Ladies, please step back a little. Please step back. Please stretch yourself a little further down. You're talking too much, too loud, okay? We are still on here. Sorting out all of these. Your name was called. That's the reason you are down here. They will sort you through and then clear up. And then we'll continue, okay?
Hyacinth Gabidon, Chevon Gabidon, Monique Gordon Murray, Dominique Garden, Marlene Graham, Kadisha Gray, Irvin Graham, Rakisha Gray, Sandy Gray, Tasha Gay Gordon Kane, Gladstone Goldburn, Simonette Graham, Leslie Grant, Judith Gordon, Shanique Graham, Mavis Gunter. Marion Gibbs, Sharon Grant, Paulette Gordon Thomas, Tremaine Graham, Twayne Graham, Michelle Gordon, Don Maureen Gordon, Everall Griffiths, Hazel Griffiths, Antonio Grant, Siebert Goldburn, Barbara Goldburn, Deanna Green, Lola Grant, Joycelyn Grant, Esther Grant Brown, Ida Grant, Reveline Greenwood, Maureen Gale, Michelle Harrison, Claudette Hanna, Jaleel Higgins, Samoy Hines, Lawayne Harridge, Trishawn Hamilton, Marjorie Hamilton, Delroy Harrison, Andrea Higgins, Gay Holness, Janelle Hemmings, Palexia Hutton, Norma Hamilton, Maxine Henry, Kayon Haylett Sargent, Charlie Howell, Violet Harding, Brittany Hines, Pauline Henry, Mary Henry, Sharon Huey, Michelle Hilton, Andrea Henderson Witter, Early Hall, Mikael Hamilton, Ronald Hall, Verona Harry, Adine Hutchinson, Kerry Hines, Shalima Harry Davis, Aswani Harris, Shushe Hepburn, Clive Huxtable, Kalia Hall, Deborah Hudson, Verona Hilton, Raina Hutchinson, Carlene Hobbs, Beverly Hutchinson, Eulalie Hepburn, Sandra Hilton Francis, Carlene Hilton, Darrell Hamilton, Carolyn Hunter, Norma Higgins, Paula Howell, Carlotta Hilton, Carlene Harris, Petrona Hall, Lorna Harvey, Deandra Henry, Laret Hamilton, Shanice Hutchinson, Mikia Hutchinson, Ashley Hutchinson. Where? Okay. Audrey Patricia Irving, Antoinette Irving Chambers, Sharon Isaacs, Shelian Irving, Danielle Johnson, Natalie Johnson, Sonia James, Jason Johnson, Sharon James Williams, Akiba Joy James, Akiba Jones Blackman, Iseline Jones Scott. Never mind. Anne-Marie Jolly, Charlotte Johnson, Patricia Jones, Charmaine Johnson, Gloria Johnson, Tatiana Jones, Martiri Jones, Julie Remiki Johnson, Sharwin James, Diana Johnson, Herling Johnson, Janet Johnson, Vina Johnson, Faye Jones, Shalisa Jones-Levy, Herma Jones, Jaleith James, Sophia, the owner of 8841 HM, you're blocking somebody and they need to move. Can you please attend to your vehicle? Sophia Johnson, Shiram James Newville, Varon Jackson, Natalie Josephs, Merlene Johnson Hemmings, Doreen Johnson, Donna Johnson Salmon, Judith Johnson Saunders, Cecilia Jones, Cheryl James, Carol Johnson, Pamela Jones Richards, May Johnson, Ashley Johnson.
All right, we will stop at this for this service. All of you are down here because your name was called. Your certificate is down here, if you heard correctly, okay? If you step back a little, then you'd make it a little easier for those who are distributing them. As soon as we clear up all of these, we'll do two other things and dismiss you. All right, just take your time. You don't have to talk so loud. Fathers, the men have prepared a beautiful area for you this morning if you want to sit down and take a Father's Day picture. To my right, right beside the gospel mobile, so as soon as we are dismissed, those fathers who want to go by and take a beautiful Father's Day picture, photo that you will remember and be able to view for the rest of your earthly life. Be happy for you to do so. Bear that in mind. All right, and all the announcements that you know have been made over time, please attend up on them. If you happen to go to the canteen or the restroom, to my right, to the back section, you will see a number of them written there on the notice board. We thank you for participating the way you have been in the services. All right, we have the promo from the men's department for the meeting on tonight. Let's get it on for everybody to see. Let me invite these people to step away to my left, please. All of you, step away.
The Power Faith Ministries International Elders Council, under the auspices of Apostle Dr. Delford Davis, presents Father's Day Special Service, Sunday, June 19, 5:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. Under the theme, Fathers, Where Are You? It's going to be an evening of praise, worship, discussions, affirmations, and reconciliations. Special guests includes Rondell Positive, gospel artists, counselors, pastors, single mothers, principals, and others. That's Father's Day Special Service, Sunday, June 19, 5:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. You need to be there.
So I hear purpose calling. Hey, this is Rondell Positive. Power Faith Ministries, Rondell Positive is coming to join you for Father's Day. Until the time, just big up the Bishop Davis. Much love, sir. And we thank you for the invite. So tell all the men, tell all of the man them in the area so for coming, because we really want to hold a reason with the man them. And not just hold a reason, but we want to speak into the lives of the men, because you are here on purpose, born for purpose, supposed to be living purpose. Why? Because I am purpose, straight. See? So we're looking forward. It's Father's Day, the 19th, and it's going to be epic. It's going to be epic, right? We're looking forward. Look here. Tell a friend to tell an next friend. Bring in the whole of the man then. I'm going to go on all the reason. Rondell Positive. I'm out.
All right, God bless you. We are coming down nicely. We will repeat this exercise in the second service. Shorten the preaching time and dismiss you 10 minutes later. Anybody got blessed here today? Water baptism on the 2nd of July, Saturday morning, 7 o'clock, usual place, Forum Beach. Spread the word and pray much for the souls that have already prepared their hearts. Marriage Enrichment Ministry goes on retreat this weekend. Plans would have already been finalized, and everybody would have bought their tickets and just waiting for this weekend. Give your support, and the Lord be with you and bless you. And of course, the men's department coming up with all kinds of goodies, calling all men, outpouring God wants you well, all men. 3 Power Pack events. Of course, this evening at 5:30. June 21, Tuesday evening, 7 o'clock. And of course, the men's conference and the men's convention. Saturday, July 9, Sunday, July 10th. Plan to give your support. Remember Elder Ashna Level in your prayers. Good to see Elder Frankito Johnson. We've been praying for you, sir. God bless you. Let us stand, please. We'll announce baby's dedication on next Sunday, God willing, when we look at the schedule of activities. Those who want to get your Power Faith Bible today, you can do so. Lift your hand and give him a praise, everybody. God is good, amen. Thanks to everybody for your prayerful support as we all lead this ministry together. All right, those who have received your certificates, may you remain standing while the others be seated, please. Stand with your certificate in hand. And AV department will take us to the multimedia screen as we affirm our commitment to be dedicated servant leaders, serving this church, serving the ministry, and serving the kingdom of God wherever he needs us. And importantly, we will not sit by and wait upon or wait to be called, but we'll offer ourselves in service. Offer ourselves in service. Please, we don't know all of your skills, talents and abilities, gifts and calling. You can make them known to us. And wherever we can fit you in service, be happy to do so. Right now we are looking for various groups or groups of persons to do some unique production for PFM Family Television. We are building the platform and we want to be able to utilize the talents among us. What are you skilled and able to do? Please let us know. Are you an outstanding storyteller? Storyteller? Yeah, there's a place for you. Are the professionals in the church at all levels, the teachers, the nurses, the doctor, the lawyer, the housekeeper, the wife, the husband, the students, and all others, we will organize you if you can organize yourself and plan a program. Woman to woman, where are they? All about men, where are they? Those programs got started well, but COVID set them back. I'm waiting on the AV. That's what I'm waiting on. All right, thank you so much. Raise your certificate, please. And look to this big screen. And when I say I, you say your name and read, not very fast, but very timely, what is on the screen. I. Put your hands together for the dedicated servant leaders. God bless you. Stand with me, everybody. I love it. Father, we thank you today for your blessings bestowed. We thank you for your favor shown. We thank you for the Holy Spirit's anointing. And as we go now, we pray that your Holy Spirit will go with us. Once again, we ask you to bless all the fathers. Remember how Elder Ashna Level, who needs a touch from you, we know you have been touching him each and every day. Continue to touch him more and more and raise him up for your glory. Thank you for Deaconess Thomas and what you have done for her. We celebrate your goodness and your favor. We pray for the Peterkin family, those at home, those abroad, that you strengthen them in this hour of their loss. Be there for them, Father, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. I am. Grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, full fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, and our rest remain and abide with us all. And everybody say, my Christian influence must be seen and must be felt. Have a wonderful rest of the afternoon. Now hear me well. You see, all of you who are standing here now, early service, leaving here at 8:45 or 9:45. You are the first ones to be here this evening at 5:30, okay? First ones. God bless you. You are dismissed.
God bless you.
Thank you for watching this live broadcast. Please like, share, and subscribe. If you were blessed and inspired, remember to visit our website at www.pfmfamily.org for more information. Stay tuned and be blessed.